I'm Brad Grillz and I'm flying over the Sahara Desert. I'm hanging onto a wing of a plane. I'm about to parachute.
Boom, 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 boom.
Okay, I'm in the Sahara Desert and it's very hot. It's important when it's in hot weather like this to get what you need and get moving quick. So I'm gonna get the lining for my parachute and I'm gonna get this, the actual parachute part itself, for possibly shelter later. And I'm gonna gather this stuff quickly and I'm gonna get moving. I'm gonna grab this belt and I'm gonna get moving. Okay, so here I am in the Sahara Desert, where in day it can reach up to 180 degrees. As you can see, the terrain is very rough, and up to hundreds of people die each day to the heat and sand monsters alone. And I'm going to show you how to survive with all my skills that I've learned in the British Special Forces and while climbing Mount Everest. Okay, so the first thing you need to do when you're in a situation like this is you need to head toward the mountains and to find water. And that's where we are headed right now. And as you can see, there's this very steep hill in front of me that I'm going to have to cross. I'm going to show you how to do it. Now, and sometimes you can go around stuff like this, but no, that's not in this case. You have to go right up it, and that's the only thing you can do. And so we're gonna show you how to do that. Okay, so here we are at the steep wall I was talking about, and I'm gonna show you how to get up it and without losing too much energy. So first thing you want to do is kick it as hard as you can. Then you want to walk backwards, jump up onto it, grab one of these things and hold it really tight. This is going to help keep your mind off of the subject of climbing up the steep wall. Then you're going to put all four on it. You're going to climb, get to the top, throw that behind you and get up. That's going to be the simplest way to get up this big hill. Okay, so here we are on top of this hill, and I could go down this way, but that would take much too long. I've only got hours of daylight, so I'm going to show you how to climb down this big wall. And first thing is first, you want to get a good footing with your foot. Then you want to get a good footing with your hand. Then you shove your foot down onto there. Go at this position, climb back up, and then run down like this, halfway, only halfway. Now, go up about two paces and kind of just slide down it and walk backwards carefully so the sand monsters do not get you. Okay, so what is first thing first while in the desert? And I think that I may have seen some over there. So if you just follow me. Okay, so there's no water over here, but I think I know something that we could do. Come on, follow me. Okay, now I could go and dig 5 foot over there for some water, but I'm gonna show you what you have to do in case there is none. I'm gonna have to pee in this bottle and drink it. Yeah. Okay, here it goes. Ugh, it tastes like bloody bristle and gritty poop and disgusting, like, ugh. But you gotta make do. Okay, I just found these ostrich tracks right here. That probably means that there's an ostrich around here, and so we want to be very cautious. Oh, quick. Okay, I got this ostrich right here, and you want to take off that top type thing right there, and you can just eat it raw, and that's what I'm going to do right here. And it's not supposed to taste good, but here it goes. It tastes like bristle, blood, and crocodile scales, and gritty maggot poop. Gotta save some for later, though. The stuff you find in the wild may not always taste good, but you want to eat as much as you can if it's edible, because stuff like that, that ostrich right there was very high in protein and vitamin C, and you know, you just want to eat as much of it as you can, because in the wild you burn calories very quickly. Hey, I'm actually, there's many mosquitoes out here, so I'm digging to see if there's some of this natural bug repellent, which I thought I saw earlier, and here we go. This is it. It's exactly what you want. It's very good bug repellent, and you just spray it on your arms like that, like so, and already I can't feel the stings of the mosquitoes, or the I can't even see the mosquitoes. So that's about the end of them. I'm gonna keep that with me in my backpack for later uses. Okay, so I'm in this hole that or tunnel that I dug in the sand, and this is gonna be my shelter for the night. I have my parachute hanging over the opening of it, so that'll keep out a lot of the animals. They won't see it, they won't come near it. I've got all my stuff in here, all my stuff from the parachute and from my supplies, the little bit that I have in here, and I'm gonna turn in for the night so I can have a lot of rest and be ready for the morning. Okay, so I just woke up, and I've actually been throwing up for a while, and it's been storming outside and getting really soupy and wet in here, and I've had a pretty bad night so far. I got about 2 hours of sleep, and about 10 minutes after about 5 increments of it, and I'm gonna get out of my tunnel and get moving, because when it's like this, you don't want to be stuck out here. Bum ba bum ba bum 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 bum. Next time on Broad vs. Wild, hunt for food, climb dangerous cliffs, and show you what it takes to get out alive.